Welcome you all for class 10 subject science. So we will continue our topic, that is metals and non-metals. The last part of it is the corrosion. What is the meaning of corrosion? Have you seen silver articles becoming black after some time? Why it is so? Because when exposed to air, it reacts with sulfur in the air and form coating of silver sulfide. Similarly, you can see the copper also. Copper vessels at home, it is there, no? After some days, what happens if it is not touched? A greenish layer you can see on the copper. Why? Because it slowly reacts. What? With carbon dioxide. The copper reacts with moist carbon dioxide in the air and slowly loses its shiny brown surface and gains a green coat. The third example is the common which you know, that is the iron rusting. Iron when exposed to moist air for a long time acquires a coating of brown flaky substance called rust. Actually, what is the meaning of corrosion? When a metal is attacked by substance around it such as moisture, acid, etc., it is said to corrode and this process is called corrosion. Clear? Okay. Now, here in this picture, figure 3.3, there are three test tubes you can see. That is, in all the three test tubes, nails are kept. One first one is with water and nails. The second one, nails are there, water is there. On the water, there is a oil layer. The third one, it has only anhydrous calcium chloride and what nails. What does that anhydrous calcium chloride does is it will dry the air, means it will remove the air. Now what happens? Actually the rusting takes place. They wanted to show us that the rusting takes place with the help of air, the moist present in the air. Now in the first test tube, the nails will get rusted. But in the second and third, the B and C, the nails will not get rust because there is no contact of air. Okay, in the B test tube, actually there is a layer of oil. As you can see that the yellow color is the layer of oil which is there. So it provides the air and water contact. Therefore, these nails will not get rusted. Similarly, in the test tube C, what happens here is they have removed the air. How? By adding anhydrous calcium chloride. So this anhydrous calcium chloride will absorb all the air and there is no air inside the test tube. Therefore, it will not rust. So now what we are learning here is the prevention of corrosion. How can we prevent corroding any substance? For iron, rusting of iron can be prevented by painting, oiling, greasing, galvanizing, chrome plating, anodizing and making alloys. What is the meaning of galvanizing? You know, painting, oiling and all. Galvanization is a method of protecting steel and iron from rusting by coating them with a thin layer of zinc. A thin layer of zinc is added for iron. It is known as galvanizing. The galvanized article is protected against rusting even if the zinc coating is broken. Clear? Galvanization is a coating of thin layer of zinc. Then next is alloy. What is the meaning of an alloy? An alloy is a homogeneous mixture of two or more metals. Okay, it is a homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous means completely mixing. Okay, then here, why alloy? What happens if we alloy the metal? The properties changes. Alloying is a very good method of improving the properties of a metal. We can get the desired properties by this method. Iron is the most widely used metal, but it is never used in pure state. This is because pure iron is very soft and stretches easily when hot. Means iron, pure iron is soft. But if it is mixed with a small amount of carbon, it becomes hard and strong. When iron is mixed with nickel and chromium, we get stainless steel. What is the mixture of stainless steel here? Iron, nickel and chromium. The mixture of iron, nickel and chromium is known as stainless steel. which is hard and does not rust. You have seen steel, right? Does it rust? No, it will not rust. Thus, if iron is mixed with some other substance, its property changes. This property of any metal can be changed if it is mixed with some other substance. It is known as what? Alloying. Alloying. A-L-L-O-Y-I-N-G. Alloying. It is prepared by first melting the primary metal and then dissolving the other metal in it in definite proportion. It is then cooled at room temperature. Clear how an alloy is made? First, melting in primary, that is whatever we want, we will melt that metal. Then, after melting, dissolving the other elements in the definite proportion. That is how much they have to add. For example, if I take the gold, okay, do you think the 24 karat gold they make the jewelry? No. Pure gold, they cannot make the jewelry in it. 24 karat gold is very soft. It is therefore not suitable for making jewelry. It is alloyed with either silver or copper to make it hard, to give the shape. Generally in India, 22 karat gold is used for making ornaments. It means 22 parts of pure gold is mixed or alloyed with 2 parts of either copper or silver. So it is said as 22 karat. 24 karat gold only biscuits will come. No jewelry with that. Okay, then coming to the next. If one of the metal is mercury, then the alloy is known as amalgam. What it is? Amalgam. The electrical conductivity and melting point of an alloy is less than that of pure metals. Whenever we are making the alloy, what happens? The physical property changes. What is the change here? The melting point of an alloy is less than that of pure metal. Now, one more example we can take is the brass. Brass is an alloy of copper and zinc. Copper and zinc. You know copper is used in electricity, right? It is a good conductor of electricity. But bronze is not good conductor of electricity. Okay, bronze is not good conductor of electricity. An alloy of copper and tin are not conductor of electricity, whereas copper is used for making electrical circuits. Solder like welding and all is done with the bronze. One more here, the iron pillar near the Qutub Minar. In the year 1600 years ago, that is before 1600, in India, there was a, it is now also it is there, the iron pillar near Qutub Minar. It is not rusted. They have developed that time only, they had developed a process which prevented iron from rusting. For its quality of rust resistance, it has been examined by scientists from all parts of the world. The iron pillar is 8 meter high and the weight 6 tons. Means before 1600 years only, they have made an alloy where the iron is not getting rusted. Is it clear? This completes the lesson and you have to complete your notes. All the question answers which are given in between of the textbook, you should write in your classwork. Thank you.